Typically, it does happen in a mental capacity, but it can also show up in your body as a feeling. Usually, it's in the solar plexus, okay? Hey guys, it's Terry. So good to see you. How's your heart today? How is your heart? I hope it's well, and if it's not, that's okay too. You're always at the right place at the right time, so no need to rush or force where you are right now, because where you are is okay, and you're okay where you are. So everybody's got their own path, everybody's got their own direction, everybody's got their own speed. It's all in divine timing. So just know that where you are okay. So today, you know what we're gonna talk about? Guess. Can you guess? Can you read my mind? We're gonna talk about telepathy. Yes, yes. We're gonna talk about telepathy today, all right? So some people know telepathy as extrasensory perception, also known as ESP. Yes, yes. It is one of the psychic abilities. Some people have it, some people don't. Some people get it, some people lose it. Some people can develop it, right? Just like any intuitive skill is like, it's a muscle. The more you practice, the better you get at it, okay? So it does take practice and it does take some skill. And if this is something that you want to work on and work towards, then you have to be kind and compassionate to yourself, right? You can't be hard on yourself. You can't push yourself, because what happens when we're working with any type of intuitive skill is if we get too much into our head, the inner critic, also known as the ego, is going to come out to play. And the ego is all about keeping us safe in our physical bodies. And when we're doing any type of intuitive or metaphysical work, we actually have to get out of our head, which means we have to leave the ego and get into the soul. And that takes us to have the ability of feeling safe and secure within ourselves. And the ego usually comes up when we're feeling threatened, we're not feeling safe, or we feel like we have to prove ourselves, right? So anything intuitive takes practice, and your whole goal of being psychic or having these telepathic skills, which we're gonna talk about in a second, is about feeling safe and comfortable. So it's about activating the parasympathetic system and not the sympathetic system, right? Right, sympathetic system, not feeling safe, survival mode, fight, flight, freeze, or fawn, okay? Those are the four survival responses when we are feeling threatened. So no, when we're doing intuitive work, right? Right, so let's talk a little bit about telepathy. What is telepathy? So telepathy is a transmission of shared communication. It's more like shared information. Sometimes it's communicated, sometimes it's not, but it's shared information from one sentient being to another, and no physical senses are being used. So you're not using your words, you're not using a phone, right? You're not using your hands to communicate, right? Right? So it's often, but not always, more of a mental type thing or a mental type of capacity. All right, you guys? So think of it as a type of mind communication. Yes, yes. But it's not necessarily that two separate minds are communicating. Remember, we are all of divine inspiration. We are all of divine energy. So we are a collective, right? I'm sure y'all have heard that we're just a drop in the ocean thing, that drop in the ocean saying, right? So the idea of separateness is not a metaphysical or spiritual belief system. And it does take several drops, right? To create something, right? So like, for example, the H2O molecule, what are those? Like, It's the hydrogen, and two hydrogen molecules and an oxygen molecule, right? And that's what creates water, right? So that could be a droplet of water, yes? So that droplet of water, when you put a lot of those droplets of water together, that creates an entire lake, ocean system, things like that, right? So we are all just part of each other, which is why the collective energy has so much, not only intensity, but it has so much of an effect energetically on us individually. Yes, yes. So that's why we always want to work on ourselves first before we can get the collective. But I'm sort of digressing here. So when we're talking telepathy, it's that the entire system is available of energy, right? Electrical connections are available to between every sentient being, okay? So typically what happens is this type of communication, which is like nonverbal, none using any of your senses, happens when there's a strong bond or an attachment to someone else or something else. And I say something else because there is animal telepathy as well. Yes, yes. Again, typically it does happen in a mental capacity, but it can also show up in your body as a feeling. Usually it's in the solar plexus, okay? So these are just different ways of communicating without our physical senses. Yes, yes. So you can deliberately send information and receive information from someone else without using any of your physical senses. Because all that's happening is, if you guys remember what energy is, energy are light waves that have data and information on it. So when you're able to hone in on a specific light wave that's carrying certain information on one end, think of a telephone. One end is one sentient being, on the other end is another sentient being. And if you're able to hone into and tap into just that one wave between you guys, you can send and receive, just like a telephone, information. Now, what are some of the signs that you've been telepathic, or you are telepathic, or you've experienced telepathy? Well, it's things like you're able to know what someone is thinking at a particular time. So it's not like a premonition, where a premonition is sort of like a prediction, something is going to happen in the future, right? So that's sort of like timeline, that's like more time traveling. But telepathy is more in the present right now. You are aware of what someone is thinking, or what someone might be feeling, or what they're experiencing in that very moment. So it's super, super common between twins, right? It's also super common between a mother and their child. And it's also super common between lovers. Yes, yes. So even if you've never had sex, typically when you have sex, there's an energetic exchange and there is a cord. That's a whole other thing. We can maybe do a topic on that another time. But there is a connection that once you tap into someone's frequency, if there is a heart link connection, okay, if you love somebody, even if you don't actually say the words "I love you" to somebody, but you love them, there is that heart link connection. Actually, even if you don't love them, there is still that connection. Sometimes anger can be that connecting factor. So it is about an attachment and a bond to another sentient being. Again, that can be an animal as well. And so there's the instinctual type of telepathy where you feel it in your body. Yes, yes. There's also the animal type of telepathy, right? What's an example of that? When birds are migrating to other areas and they start doing that entrainment, right? Where one bird starts flying in one formation and then they all just kind of like know what to do because a signal is being brought out, like emitted, boop, 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 or, you know, like schools of fish or pods of whales, right? That is another type of telepathy, right? It's a signal being sent out very deliberately, and it's received and responded to. Yes, yes. There is also the mental. So with us humans, it's typically going to be the mental and the instinctual. And most common or easily accessed is going to be that instinctual, right? In that moment, you're like, I know that this person is feeling scared, right? Empaths have this ability very clear and this sensitivity very, very clear. So, yes, you can practice this. And it's really a cool thing to practice when you can send information back and forth to each other and not have to use any physical tangible tool like a phone or a carrier pigeon for fuck's sake, right? Because those are used a lot these days. Yes, yes, yes. So, that's the thing about telepathy. Have you ever experienced telepathy? If you have, comment below because I'd love to hear about it. I recently, in the past 6 months, have, I don't want to say developed this skill because I've had this skill, but I didn't realize that I was having this skill and I sort of came more online with it, being more consistent that it's been happening. And at first I thought I was going insane until I actually got confirmation from someone else that they were also sending information through the ether, right? Remember, energy can penetrate matter. So it doesn't matter that there is actually something physical there because energy can go right through it because those energetic waves are moving faster and slower moving waves are density and matter. So, it was happening to me and I started to be able to track when it's happening for me personally. And some of you ladies may experience this as well. I don't know. But mine comes with my moon cycle and typically my telepathy gets super heightened. And I, of course, I needed that validation and I'm so grateful I got it because for months I thought I was going insane. And I'm like, I'm pretty much a sane person. Yes, I'm psychic and yes, I talk to dead people, but I mean, I'm pretty pragmatic. I'm pretty logical. I'm like, I don't know what's going on with me. Do I need to like check myself in? Like what is going on here? You know, so it can be nerve-wracking when you first when you first come online to it and first experience it. And then once you can get some consistency with it through practice, or you start to notice that it's cyclical through your experiences, then of course you can trust it, right? Just like anything else in this metaphysical esoteric world, once you start seeing consistencies with the same results and the validation, then you can feel like, okay, I can trust this. So telepathy is a very real thing. They've done many, many, many experiments on it. If you're gonna Google it, there's gonna be a shit ton of articles on it. So it's not an imagined thing. So I just wanna let you know right now that if you are thinking or, you know, imagining something is, you know, is happening to you and you're like, I think I'm going insane. The odds are you're not. You're just using your extrasensory perception and it's coming in more of a mental capacity without any physical tangibility, which is like how a lot of this works anyways. But telepathy between people and animals it's a very real thing and it can be really cool to play and practice with. And it is a skill that can be developed. All right, you guys, so don't freak out if you are, if you find that you're telepathic. And gentlemen, just because you don't have a monthly cycle doesn't mean that you can't also, you know, have some sort of flow with it. So it, again, it's a practice thing. So maybe you have a cycle or maybe you have a flow or maybe there are certain times of the year, certain times of the month, certain times of the day, certain times of the week, whatever, that you're noticing that, this is pretty interesting. I'm thinking about so-and-so and I'm feeling this. What you can do is you can reach out to that person, or what might happen is you can send information and then they might actually reach out back to you because they received it. And that's pretty cool because it's deliberate. Yes, 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 yes. What am I always saying? You stay connected. Stay connected to your friends and family. Stay connected to yourself. And of course you can stay connected to me. Maybe you can send me some telepathy and see if I'll respond back to you. I mean, it's a practice thing. I am not a master of it, not even close. I am still in the wee beginning stages of it, but you never know, we can play, right? Send me a telepathic message. But either way, just stay connected and you can check me out at terryhuberman.com, and I'll see ya on the flip side.